Good morning, students. So students, today we will start with a new lesson in civics. The name of the lesson is district administration. So district administration means management or task. It maintains law, orders, right, which we have to follow. Let's start. Do such questions occur to you too? The Zila Parishad is a part of the rural local government system. That is the Panchayati Raj system. We have learnt about the rural local government bodies and the urban local government bodies and who are the people over there to take care of that. But in the Maharashtra, the administration of the district is shared by both the Zila Parishad and district collector. The union government and state government both participate in this administration. Now, state government is a government who takes care of a particular state, and union government is the government of all the states included. Okay, now let's see the district collector. The district collector is the head of the district administration. He is appointed by the state government. Now, what are the work he has to do? He has to perform many functions, from collecting agricultural tax to maintaining law and order in the district. We can see what these functions are from the chart given below. So let us see the chart. The first one is agriculture. Now he has to collect agricultural tax. Okay, so tax also, that is the work of the district collector. Then he needs to implement laws relating to agriculture. Then he also has to provide relief in case of drought and scarcity of fodder. Okay, in case of drought where the land becomes full dry, they don't have water. So in case of that, he has to provide food. Now let's see the law and order. It is to establish peace in the district. That is the most important thing. Wherever you are staying, there should be peace. Then to maintain social harmony, that means all the people are equal. You should not discriminate, okay? Then to restrict unlawful assembly, impose curfew if required. Now let's see the election officer. Now to ensure smooth conduct of election, what is the work of the election officer? He has to conduct the smooth functioning of the elections when the elections are held. To take necessary decision related to the electoral process. So when the elections are held, when the election is going on, he has to take decision. Whatever decisions are to be taken, it is taken by the election officer. Then to update the voters list. The people who are going to vote, So he has to update that. Okay. Then next is disaster management. To take quick decision during the times of disaster and prevent or minimize the damage. Now, when a disaster happens, when a natural disaster happens, it doesn't tell you and happen. So we have to be prepared for that as well, that when it is going to cause any damage, we have to be alert. To give orders to the disaster management units and cell. So there are certain groups regarding to disaster management. Okay, after the disaster, what all work they have to do, that has to be seen. To rehabilitate those affected by disaster, if they have lost their homes, you have to take them to a safer place. Okay, so that also has to be taken care by the disaster management. Next, let us see, do you know, why is it important to maintain social harmony? The difference of opinions, disputes and conflicts in the society must be resolved by peaceful means. Now, when we are living in the society, there are sometimes arguments, there are disputes, there are conflicts. But it's not like that we, we also have conflicts in our family, with your siblings, with your brother, sister. But it's not like that we don't talk to that person forever. We talk it. So we have to resolve that by peaceful means, by talking. However, when this does not happen, it gives rise to tensions. Okay, when you don't talk to a person properly, it irritates in your mind. So we have to sort out that by peaceful means. If this lead to violent incidents, it disturbs social harmony, right? Then there is no peace in the society. So you should solve it. It acts as an obstacle to our progress. Then our country can't progress if this is happening in our country. public properties damage. The district collector makes efforts to prevent such occurrence, but it is the duty of the citizens also to help maintain social harmony. Now it is the duty of the district collector as well as of us. If we want our country to move further, we have to see to solve the problems by peaceful means, not by violence. Okay, next is Tehsildar. Now, the Tehsildar is a collector of a revenue department. Okay, now there is a Tehsildar for every taluka and tehsil, like taluka, Borivali, right? So, there is a person kept for that. As a judicial officer, he gives judgment to resolve conflicts at the local level. The Tehsildar has the responsibility of maintaining peace and order in the taluka. Let us see the next. That is the chief of the district police. In Maharashtra, there is a superintendent of police at every district headquarter. Now, wherever you go, after a certain place, there is police station, right? He is the chief police officer of the district. He helps the district collector to maintain peace and order in the district. So you see police station, when there is a certain argument at the signals where there is lot of traffic, then the police comes to solve out that problem. So what is the duty? To maintain peace and order in the everywhere. In the city, the police commissioner has the responsibility of maintaining law and order. Means there are certain rules which we have to follow. Now let us look at the next point, that is district courts. Now you all might be knowing that there are three types of court: local court, high court, supreme court. Okay, when the problem is not solved in the local court, it goes to the high court. When it's not solved to the high court, it goes to the supreme court. So let us see. The courts at the district level have to perform the function of resolving disputes. Now what, why is the court kept? To solve problems of the people, delivering judgments and ensuring that conflicts are resolved at the earliest. So whenever a case takes place, we see to it that it has to be, it should be solved at the earliest. Okay. The Constitution of India has established an independent judiciary. At the apex of that system is the Supreme Court of India. Means at the high position is the Supreme Court. Below this are the high courts and below them the lower courts. These include district courts, taluka court and revenue court. Now the court at the district level is known as the district court. The district court has a chief district judge and some other judges. Now when we go to the court, we see there's a lawyer, there are judges who fight for the case, right? Both the parties fight on a particular topic. Their main function is to hear the various cases in the district and deliver the final judgment. So what does the lawyer does? He hears both of them things. We need to have proof also, and then the final judgment is given. One can appeal against the judgment of the taluka court in the district level. And let us see what is always remember. It is important to remember to remain alert during the time of crisis. Whenever natural disaster occurs, we have to be alert. To face a disaster, one needs the help of people as well as different systems and organization. In order to be able to contact them urgently, one should display the contact numbers of the police, fire brigade, hospital, blood banks at a prominent place in the house. So, during crisis, anything happens, what we should do? We should have all these numbers like the police, fire brigade, hospitals, blood bank. Okay, so you don't know whenever you will need it. So we should have it. Let us see now disaster management. Sometimes we have to face a calamity. We know a natural disaster can occur anytime. It doesn't tell you an occur. So we have to face a calamity. It could be a natural disaster like floods, fire, a cloud burst, cyclone, earthquake, landslide, or problems like riots, bomb blast, breaking of a dam, epidemics, etc. So these are, any problem can occur anytime. So we have to be alert. These disaster leads to loss of human lives and displacement of people, besides tremendous financial loss. Now when a natural disaster occurs, after that, you know, it leads to loss of property, Then when a person's house is destroyed, damaged, then again we need to build. So that also causes a lot of financial losses. Therefore, the issue of rehabilitation becomes important. Disaster management is a process which enables one to face a disaster in a scientific and organized manner. The entire machinery of a district is involved in this process. Advances in technology make it possible for us to get prior information about several kinds of disaster. Nowadays, we come to know that when a cyclone will take place, when a storm will come, with the help of the latest technology. Okay, so we are alert. For example, a system which can predict and warn us of floods or storms has been developed. This helps us to be better prepared to face the disaster. Okay, so you can read these boxes, which are, that is, do you know? Okay, so here we end with this chapter. We will learn the next chapter in the next video. Thank you for listening, children. Goodbye. Take care.